system. So if a survey were done, you're going to find that the number of people that are actually on the system is extremely small. To rely on that solely, which seems to be your focus because you think it's a great system, I think in this day and age is totally ridiculous. I think you have to have multiple systems of communication, as many as possible. You may not like social media, but the Facebook, and Mr. Gallagher, Committeeman Gallagher said, as a committeeman, the first he heard of it was on Facebook. So I think you have to look at every possible communication vehicle available. And I really strongly suggest that you take the advice of the mayor, which is to get together with Mr. Quirk, who understands this. We have a whole lot more information here in the township about how to communicate effectively than I believe that you do based on your comments. So it's not a criticism, it's just an observation.
No, it's you know, we'll take it. I think there are a lot of different perspectives on this, and Facebook sounds like it's very popular within this community. Then
it's a form of social network. There are probably others, I mean, you know, staff, but I think there's got to be something more affirmative than just Facebook. A lot of people don't use it. Our seniors are not using social networks. Our seniors are not using a lot of data. Our own representative for the water company says he hates it. But nevertheless, Mr. Anacone,
I don't use any of it.
How would you like?
No, let's get it straight, okay? I said I didn't hate it. I don't care what you guys do. Do all the things you want to, jumping back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, okay? I'm just telling you, there are how many seniors represent this town? I think you one time said there's something like about 50% of the households here are seniors, okay? And I don't know. Joe, you can check me down.
28%, Mr. Anacone, but go ahead.
28%, that's right. Hey, that's right, 28%. 95 years old, but I still have something up here, okay? And I'm telling you that there's a hell of a lot of people that don't subscribe to Facebook, or my grandchildren do, okay? Or the millennials do, but us seniors, we have more to do than just to play there all day long with the phones and stuff, okay? So I'm telling you that the means of communication, you should be very careful of, because you have 20% of the seniors in this town who probably don't take any of that stuff.
I fully agree. Now, here's
all right.
I'm
going to tell you what the best is, okay?
Well, you tend to tell me, because I was going to ask you what the best is.
The best is the good old days. Get some loudspeakers mounted on the police cars, and the easiest thing in the world is send the police cars in the neighborhood with the blaring horns and the good old time and blow everything out of bed. George is agreeing with me.
Tell them, wake up,
call your neighbor, make sure he's aware of what's going on. You talk about your neighborhood. Watch that you have, that the police department is so anxious to set up in all the neighborhoods. Get it set up, the neighborhood watch, get your neighbors to talk to each other, which they don't do anymore because they're too busy with all these communications you guys have, okay? It's that simple, so simple, and you solve all your problems.
A couple
of loudspeakers going through the neighborhood.
How do we get our seniors to stop talking?
Okay. Now that's it. I'm going home. That's past my bedtime.
That's an old-fashioned reverse 911.
Right.
This is what I said in the beginning of this presentation, didn't I? In a true emergency, and I have not discussed this with Chief Roddy, and I have not discussed it with our Office of Emergency Management. In a true emergency, doorbells will be rung. No loudspeakers. Doorbells will be rung.
Both.
A neighborhood will be segregated. It will be policed to the point where people are individually known. Doorbells are known and wrong. That's the way to do it.
Yes, and it is the responsibility of the township committee to make sure there's a good communication system.
And we
not the water company, or the electric company, or the gas company. They can do what their job has to do with their utility. But it's a basic problem with the township committee to make sure that all of their citizens are being taken care of.
There's no question.
End of speech. Sorry.
That's why we're here tonight, isn't it? Shouldn't be on.
That's why we're here tonight. But let me tell you something. When your township committee has to wait hours to get the proper communications of the kind of language that we have to put up on our Everbridge message, that's delay is what we're concerned with.
And that's something else, as your representative, your appointed representative, I will make sure